late 1990s, the Glenbrook Vintage Railway leased steam incorporated locomotives J1234 and DA's 1410 and 1431 for use on their line and mainline excursions. Engines were leased to the railway to assist with a loco shortage, the GVR's Mallet being the only operational steam locomotive available for service. This was changed in 1998 when JA1250 re-entered service after a lengthy overhaul. With the two J-class locomotives in service, the railway took advantage of the opportunity by operating frequent double-headed trains. As of May 2015, 1234 and 1410 were still on site at the railway until the 6th of June. This is a behind the scenes story of their move. What we're preparing for is towing DA 1410 and J1234 back to Steam Incorporated in Paekok. The two engines have been up at Glenbrook for the last, we've counted about 15 years. And what we're doing is returning to the owners, which is Steam Incorporated in Wellington. So what we've done today is prepare the train, put the train into its consist. The steaming boys have come up, it's running under their license, the train, so they'll be doing all the TXO tests tomorrow, checks and everything, make sure the train's all good to run. So the preparation to do that is both locomotives have to be inspected over the pit, checking wheel measurements, brake readings, air tests, checking under the rigging, everything like that. Make sure the locomotives are fit for the tow. They're both going to be towed dead. Also, travelling on the train, the delivery service back will be four RES mainline carriages, two tin belly cars, an FM band, and the old green band, the green FM. The big help's been from volunteers. that have helped us out over the last 3 weekends to over a month really to prepare everything for the trip down, from washing carriages to helping us inspect the carriages over the pits, helping us, like volunteers who are doing all sorts of jobs, from fetching the tools to help us fix things under there or measure things, to filling out the documentation, which is a big part of this trip. So it's a huge job. It's sort of a one-off job in a way, because it's not often that locomotives get towed dead around the country, especially from Auckland to Wellington. So it's been a huge task, and this weekend it's finally come to the day when it's all going to happen.
we got up here successfully from Pukewari with DE507, so now we're just waiting on Dean McCoy's DA1429 to arrive from Westfield. It should be here within about 3/4 of an hour, and we'll be coupling up to the train and heading south. Saturday evening on day one of the delivery trip back to Paekok. We're just cruising into the Monga Merino swamp now, just falling into darkness. And we've had a few mechanical checks along the way for J1234 and DA1410, and everything's going good, so now we're eyeballing it to Te Rapa for the night. Here we are on day two of the delivery trip. We've just left Te Amuru now. Everything seems to be going good so far. We have a DX on the front this morning, J1429 posing a few problems yesterday. So far so good, so onwards and upwards. Home run to Paekok now. We've just left National Park. Everything seems to be going smoothly, and the trip up the spiral is very good. So, yeah, onwards and upwards we go.
2 weeks later, the train was to return to the GVR with the DA delivery excursion. This was to coincide with Steam Incorporated's Double Thunder excursion. Unfortunately, a weather bomb hit the Wellington and Manawatu areas the previous night, causing washouts and floods along the track. This meant the Double Thunder excursion was postponed until July, and also cancelled the first day of the DA delivery trip. This meant the entire trip to Auckland had to be completed in a day, meaning a 6 a.m. departure from Paekok. The remains of the storm can be clearly seen.
Good morning, I'm Terry Hunt. I'm the guard for this part of the trip. And so far our morning's been not too crash hot. We've been late away from Paekokariki, and also, according to this, we're more or less an hour and a bit behind schedule, mainly due to a loco being late arriving at Paekok. We've had two or three freight crossings. They've been pretty good. And then we were held up again just out of Palmerston for what we believe is a diesel spill somewhere, which we've never seen any sign of. But now we're back on track and we're about 15 minutes out of Martin.
Hi, I'm Alan Berry, President of the Railway Enthusiast Society and excursion organiser of this DA Delivery Delights excursion to Paraparao in return. I'd like to thank Steam Incorporated for their great cooperation and assistance in organising this trip in conjunction with the RES. And while it has been a very interesting weekend, not quite what was planned, we have had a great time, and I think the passengers have enjoyed themselves with what has been quite a challenging and different occasion.